A vaquita is a tiny porpoise. Well, it was a tiny porpoise, maybe. Numbers have become so low that no one really knows how many are left. And if there are any left, the number is certainly below 12. But should we care? I think we should. Firstly, this tiny little porpoise is almost certainly going to join the ranks of species that have been driven to extinction by humans, and really soon. We're actually watching this species go extinct in real time. We should also care because their babies are the size of little footballs, and they're the cutest things ever. Like any species going extinct, the vaquita has its own story. But the vaquita, which means tiny cow in Spanish, has its own story wrapped up in economics, culture, and conservation. You see, vaquita live in the northern Gulf of California in Mexico. They evolved from a group of porpoises that swam into the Gulf, eventually becoming their own species and claiming the mantle of world's smallest cetacean, which is a science word meaning whales, dolphins, and porpoises. Now, until recently, this area was just a bunch of little fishing villages. However, the effect of extinction of another species made this little area very interesting indeed. For a long time, the swim bladder of the bahaba, which is a fish native to the coastal waters around China, was highly prized for its purported curative powers. And for those of you who don't know what a swim bladder is, like I didn't know, it's basically a balloon inside of a fish that lets it move up and down in the water column. Issues trying to find the bahaba in its dwindling numbers turn people to look at the next best thing, the totoaba, which just happens to be the little vaquita's neighbor in the Gulf of California. Suddenly, fishermen in this economically depressed area could make thousands of dollars a day just by catching a few fish. So they unrolled their nets and they got to work. Unfortunately for the vaquita, and also for the totoaba as it turns out, the gill nets that fishermen use are virtually invisible to our tiny friends, who rely on echolocation underwater to find their way around. This led to lots of them becoming stuck in nets, and unfortunately, lots of dead porpoises, which has led us to the situation we find ourselves in today. The vaquita's fate was not always a foregone conclusion. Lots of things could have turned the tide in favor of the tiny cows. Political will to invest in alternative fishing technology, enforcement of the illegal trade in totoaba swim bladders, or even a concerted effort to retrain fishermen could have saved the vaquita. But none of those things did, because none of them happened in a way meaningful enough for long-term change. So at the end of the day, why is it important? The vaquita is important because it's emblematic of the biodiversity crisis that is seizing our planet. More species are going extinct, and more quickly, now, than ever before in Earth's history. And just to spell it out for you, our impact on the Earth is literally greater than an 80-kilometer asteroid slamming into the Yucatan Peninsula at 20 kilometers per second. You know, that asteroid that killed the dinos. So while it might not save the vaquita, next time you're thinking about driving to the cafe to get a drink in a single-use plastic cup with a single-use plastic straw, just maybe think of your new favorite tiny porpoise's little football babies and be like, I'm gonna find an alternative that might not be as hard on the planet. You know, for the tiny porpoise cuddles. Thanks for watching, everyone. To learn more about the vaquita, click the links in the description below. And if you like this video, I'd be grateful if you'd hit like or subscribe to my channel, which helps me keep making videos just like this one. Until next time, stay curious.